Hey there again, TikTakers! Imagine that there is something that's making you feel unwell. Maybe you feel some strange pains, but nothing you try eliminates them. However, your doctor then prescribes you some special pills that, according to him, are extremely effective. Excellent, right? However, what would you say if later on you discovered that those pills you took had no medication in them at all? Well, what happened to your body in that situation is what's known as the placebo effect. Have you ever heard of it? A placebo is something that, by itself, will have no direct consequences on whatever issue is trying to be treated. In other words, a placebo will have no physical qualities that will impact the symptoms directly. However, other factors around the placebo will contribute towards our body getting better. What are those factors exactly? Well, there are a few. But before we continue, we want to make clear that when we say placebo, we don't mean just a pill or a fake medicine. Since a placebo can also be an entire treatment, therapy, and even surgery. The first one of the factors which influence the efficacy of a placebo are the expectations of the person who is going to receive it. That is, how strongly the patient believes that through that medium they will get better. This could happen if, through the patient's life, they've had experiences in which a particular treatment has cured them. And so, the more the patient believes they will be cured by a treatment, the more prone the patient will be to getting better. Now, TikTakers, this only applies to very specific instances. There are many people with particular pathologies who, despite strongly believing they will get better, never do. We're only saying that the attitude with which a person faces adverse situations is key in many instances, but isn't always decisive. Another factor which has an influence over the effectiveness of a placebo is whatever view the patient has about the person recommending it. For instance, if we trust our doctor very much, we'll be more convinced that whatever they are recommending to us will be the best thing we can take. However, the circumstances and the entire context of the corresponding illness and symptoms also play a role. Moreover, for a placebo to be effective, it is essential that it has a proper presentation. For instance, sugar can be used as a placebo, but if it is presented to us in its common, granulated form, the placebo will not work. Now, if we are presented with a sugar pill instead, that can work much better as a placebo. Sometimes, as a placebo, doctors can prescribe medicine with no effects or medicine for other less severe symptoms, making the person think they are actually taking a stronger medicine. This usually works with hypochondriacs, people who believe they are constantly getting ill even though they are actually fine. In this case, that's known as using a pseudo-placebo because the patient would be taking an actual medicine but not the medicine they think. The placebo effect also has an opposite effect, known as the nocebo effect. That is, when people believe that the treatment they are going to get will negatively affect their health, and thus, those expectations result in the person actually developing issues. Again, TikTakers, the use of placebos are focused on very specific cases, and usually doctors don't use them because it's ethically questionable. The patient should always be informed of all the treatments and medications they will receive, so it can be considered unethical to trick them into taking a placebo. That said, placebos are usually used in clinical studies in order to test medicines or study diseases. It has been proved that placebos do have an effect at a neurological level, so experts believe they can be useful for particular pathologies related to epilepsy, anxiety, Parkinson's, dementia, and others. Placebos can also have a relaxing effect on patients suffering from certain kinds of pains, helping them suffer less. It is difficult to understand how something with no pain-killing chemicals can do something like that, but many studies prove that it is possible, TikTakers. Although, as we mentioned before, a placebo must always be prescribed by a doctor. Overall, they know what's best for us. And finally, remember that a healthy mind is key to having a healthy body, so always take good care of yourselves. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to see more Draw My Life videos, subscribe to our channel. See you in the next episode!